This is Lenny Farlee, Purdue University Extension Forester. Now let's ID that tree. On this edition of ID That Tree, we're actually going to ID something that's not a tree at all, but important for you to recognize as you enjoy yourself or do some work out in the woods, and that is poison ivy. There is a well-known old rhyme that says, "Leaflets three, let it be," which applies to poison ivy, and it's a good one to remember. One of poison ivy's best identification characteristics are the three leaflets on the compound leaf. These leaflets may have relatively large teeth on them in many cases, but in some cases, as you see here, we don't see much in the way of teeth. So there's quite a bit of variability on that. Poison ivy, as indicated, can be a vine that clings to the bark of trees, climbing up actually far into the canopies in many cases. I've seen some very large diameter poison ivy. And when they get very big, they actually will stick out branches away from the sides of the trees, looking like branches of the trees themselves in some cases. Poison ivy can also be a ground cover. We've got a small pot poison ivy growing on the forest floor right down here at the base of this tree. And it can even be a small shrub along fence lines in some cases. Poison ivy has alternate leaf arrangement, meaning the leaves alternate back and forth on the stems. It has elongated buds that start out relatively green but ultimately will turn a very light tan and have almost a fuzzy leathery appearance to them. We do have some other vines in Indiana that do some of the same habits as poison ivy in terms of climbing trees. Things like Virginia creeper are also fairly common. Virginia creeper looks a lot like poison ivy but has five leaflets typically. We can also find grapevine, but grapevine typically aren't clinging to the bark of trees. So, remember these characteristics to help you identify poison ivy, and make sure you keep your distance. If you think you've actually come in contact with poison ivy, one of your best treatments is actually to get someplace where you can use some soap and water to clean the oils off your skin, and that should help you avoid that nasty itch.